my brother. Here he comes.
Namaste. Welcome to Wheelchair Travels with Vineet.
I'm Vineet.
And I'm his mom. This video is in continuation to our Taj Mahal Agra Fort trip series, which we did along with our Delhi trip in 2013.
Don't forget to watch the previous episodes of this trip.
Due to time constraints, we could not see all of the buildings in the Fatehpur Sikri area, but how much we saw was quite an eye-opener where accessibility was concerned.
Even places like the Buland Darwaza, which are so high, were accessible by wheelchair just due to well-placed wooden ramps.
So let's go on straight to the video and see why we were so thankful to the Archaeological Survey of India in this particular place.
Fatehpur Sikri, a UNESCO World Heritage Site and a famous tourist attraction, is home to Mughal Emperor Akbar's wife Jodhabai's palace, the Jama Mosque, the Buland Darwaza, and a tomb of the Sufi saint Salim Chishti, among many other famous monuments, each of which is an integral part of the Indian heritage. Fatehpur Sikri is located at a distance of around 43 kilometers from Agra and was built in the 16th century. From the parking space, we had to hop on a mini tourist bus run by the Uttar Pradesh State's Agra Development Authority, free of cost. A 5-minute ride took us to the base of the fort. There, a young boy insisted to be our guide for a small fee, and we obliged. And there were ramps everywhere. We entered the fort through the Badshahi Darwaza, which is the eastern entrance, and we were impressed by the vastness of the space enclosed. Then we walked to the Buland Darwaza, which is the largest gate in the world. It was built by the great Mughal Emperor Akbar to commemorate his victory over the state of Gujarat. It was built as a gateway to his newly built city of Fatehpur Sikri. It is 54 meters in height. There was a flight of 4 or 5 steps leading to an open space before the huge 42 steps leading down to the city started. Then we walked back into the fort and we were drawn to the beautiful singing inside the tomb of the Sufi saint Salim Chishti. We were informed that Vineet's wheelchair was not allowed inside, so none of us went in. Can someone give us a valid explanation for this?
सलीम चिश्ती का मकबरा है ये।
And it was finally time to move out as the last minibus would be leaving soon. Nevertheless, as we passed the high Buland Darwaza on our way back, we couldn't help feel a sense of gratitude to the Archaeological Survey of India for making Vineet's visit an almost 100% accessible one.
Guys, I'm Ryan, Vineet's brother. Give me a second, please. Hi everyone, how are you all in these trying times of the COVID pandemic? It has sent us humans into the confinement of our homes, but left the birds and other living creatures free to breathe in the fresh air, which is non-toxic at all. Something to think about. Well, I'm very unhappy I cannot meet Vineet Bhaiya this year and shoot videos with him. So I thought, let me send him and you all the most important message. Hashtag stay home, stay safe. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our video. See you again in the next video of Wheelchair Travels with Vineet. Until then, Ryan signing off. Bye and take care.
Stay tuned for our next episodes on our trip to Dehradun and Mussoorie, which we did in 2014.
Please like, comment, share, subscribe, click on the bell notification and follow on Instagram @ Wheelchair Travels with Vineet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Peace.
So let's go on straight to the video and
question mark.